Hey, Psych2Goers. Ever wonder what the secret to life was? What's the key to finding real, lasting happiness and fulfillment? Or how to make all your dreams come true? Chances are, you probably have. But what we don't realize is that figuring out what doesn't make us happy is what's holding us back and getting in the way of everything we want. So here are five of the most common things we struggle with that hold us back from living a great, fulfilling life. Number one, other people's opinions. Are you always changing how you act and behave because of what other people think? Deep down inside, you may know that you shouldn't let other people and their opinions dictate how you live your life, but it's also only human to crave love, acceptance, and approval. This desire to belong and to receive validation from those around you may make it easy to make the mistake of changing who you are to accommodate the people you care about. But caring too much about other people's opinions to the point where you don't even get a say anymore in what it is you want to do with your life may only serve to trap you in a life of regret and resentment. Number two, your relationships. Aside from the opinions of others, you may also be guilty of letting your attachments to other people keep you from living your best life. Perhaps you're afraid to move to a new city, even though you really want to, because you'll have to leave your closest friends and family. Or maybe you want to go to a different college or declare a different major from your friends because you're afraid you'll drift away from them. Although it's always nice to take the people you love into consideration when making big life decisions, it's equally important to consider yourself and what you want as well. Even if you may think it's selfish to do so, prioritizing your own needs and wants is important for your own happiness and well-being. Number three, your past. Do you find yourself falling into the same problematic patterns over and over again, even when you already know better? It's been said that until you heal from your past, you create from your past. By letting your past control your future, you may be stopping yourself from getting to where you really want to go. Real authenticity and happiness comes from making peace with your past, letting it go, and learning to be more intentional with everything you do moving forward. Align your actions with the future you want instead of the past you're trying to outrun. And you might just find that it radically changes your life for the better. Number four, negative emotions. Are you always looking for ways to hide how you feel? Negative emotions are labeled as such because no one ever wants to feel that way, whether it's anger, jealousy, hatred, or fear. Negative emotions can feel corrosive to your mental and emotional well-being when you let them get the better of you. But that doesn't mean you should repress or deny them either. All emotions serve a purpose, so when you try to repress or dismiss them, they may only build up and overwhelm you at a later time. Instead, you may want to try to identify why you're feeling this way, learn from it, and find constructive ways to address the issue and resolve it. Number five, limiting beliefs. American businesswoman and multimillionaire Mary Kay Ash once said, "Many people limit themselves to what they think they can do, but you can only go as far as your mind lets you. What you believe, you can achieve." There's certainly a lot of truth to be found in her statement, because all too often you may find that you are your own worst enemy when it comes to achieving success and happiness. And one of the worst ways of self-sabotage is when you buy into your own limiting beliefs and let them control your life. Perhaps you think that you're only worthy if you have the love and approval of others, or that life is only worth living if you do something great. Once you learn to overcome these limiting beliefs and start believing that anything is possible, you may find that your potential becomes unlimited. Did you relate to any of these signs we've mentioned? Let us know in the comments below. If you found this video helpful, be sure to like, subscribe, and share this video with those who might benefit from it. And don't forget to hit the notification bell icon to get notified whenever Psych2Go posts a new video. The references and studies used in this video are added in the description below. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.